Good morning, everybody. This is Brittany at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. There's Smalls up there in her little sunspot. Hi, lady! So I wanted to show you guys Flint and his castle of destruction. And check in. Let you guys also know that Simba Savannah came back outside yesterday afternoon.
Hi, mister! Hi, mister!
You guys know that on Monday we had Amanda Tiger and Simba Savannah in the hospital for some checkups, and Simba checked out to be perfectly A-okay. Just a picky eater, which is not uncommon for Savannah. So he's back outside and doing well. So you guys also saw Monday evening Afton brought this Isby boy. He's like, oh, but it's breakfast time. Brought this amazing castle that Colin Marmalade and Catman Chris donated, and we gave it to Flint, and it used to look like a castle. Now it's just a pile of boxes. You had so much fun. And Afton put her video out yesterday, so if you haven't seen that, it's at bigcattv.com. He's got his zoomies going on right now. She also posts all of those videos on our Facebook page as well, so you can go to our page to see all of that. You had so much fun, didn't you, sir? Do not jump from there. Thank you. There was, he's like, I'll jump from this last little step. So, happy birthday, Cynthia. Yeah, I agree. I think Flint's aspiration is to be a cameraman someday. So, yep, he stormed the castle. Total destruction. He had a blast. It'll probably stay in there for a while. It's not really hurting anything, and unless it rains and everything gets really soggy and gross. So he'll probably have that for a little while longer to play with. You know we can't walk over here and not say hi to Smalls. Are you instigating? You instigating his craziness? Hi, baby girl. Can hear her purring. So this is Smalls' Bobcat. We just got started. I'm multitasking. I ran up to the Keeper Cafe to get a bunch of paper towels and toilet paper because our party house building, which is where my office and Carol and Jay's offices are, we have absolutely like no paper products out there. So ran up, loaded up my cart, and then I was like, oh, let's do a live. We'll check in with everybody that you might be wondering about. So we just saw Simba Savannah, Flint and his castle over here with Smalls. The feeders are on their way, so everybody's very focused on that food time. So we're gonna make our way out to see Amanda as well. Amanda went back out into her enclosure late Monday night, and she's still only in one small section of it. That's just to ensure that she's completely out of the sedation before she's near swimming pools or anything.
Hi, sweet boy. Let me show you one more time. Very good boy. You hear your feeding cart.
Front gate is open. We may need somebody to open the big white gate though.
Comes your feeder. It looks like it's Fred.
So Fred's feeding Running Bear. Running Bear's kind of crazy, so we always have to toss a piece kind of out of his lockout and give him a second so that he'll clear his plate area, and then we can get the rest of the food in there. One of our oldest bobcats, he's still very feisty.
So Running Bear got some, looks like he's got our carnivore diet, the mush, and he's got some chicken thigh in there as well. thank you, Deb, for mentioning sponsoring cats. I got an updated email this morning about where all the sponsorships stood for 2019. And there's still quite a few cats that have less than five sponsors, so you can sponsor any of the cats at bigcatrescue.biz. And right on the front page, there's a sponsor kit link. It's actually what I spent my whole day yesterday doing, was adding a new feature to our Shopify store. So there's now, if you go to shop by category and you scroll down, there's now a shop by design, and then it'll show you a bunch of thumbnails of every t-shirt design that we currently carry at bigcatrescue.biz. So you can shop by design now. And I'm going to keep that updated anytime we add something new. Going to town, sir. I saw that Bailey only has two sponsors. I think Simba Savannah is another one that was under five. I know Ariel Bobcat was under five. Really, any of the shy cats. So the cats that we just don't get to show you all that often, they're the ones that typically have the least sponsors. And the brand new cats. I mean, even Flint had very few late last year. I think it bumped up by the end of the year, but. All right. Not off the top of my head, I can't tell you. The ones I just named, I know for sure, but we have 60 cats here, so. Can't remember them all off the top of my head, and there's no way to look it up at the moment. I don't know if we'll post a whole list anyway, but what we'll probably do is just make sure that we keep frequently letting you guys know the tallies as we know them. Because the way the sponsor kits work is, you know, you can buy the sponsorship kit, but then you have to wait until you get your form in the mail to fill it out. So at that point, we might know, oh, we just sold 50 Bobcat sponsorship kits. But we don't know who those people are going to sponsor until we get all that information back. So it's a little bit of a process. But I'm sure we will definitely keep trying to push those in the year 2020. We want everybody to have as many sponsors as possible. Especially these youngins, because they're the ones that are going to be around. There goes Filmo. He's caught a flash of him. So if you guys know, I wasn't here when they did it, but they moved Nabisco. Nabisco Bobcat was here in this enclosure, right next to Filmo. And we moved him to Zimba's old enclosure. And now Filmo has access to this whole new front section. And a couple people have spotted him up there in the really early or really late hours. I think he was trying to eat breakfast. Hey, Natalie. But he's been enjoying having some extra space. But that brings me to Nabisco. Hi, mister. Nabisco's been having a blast. This is his new feeding lockout. He knows right where it is. So Nabisco Bobcat now lives right across the street from Zucari. He's right next door to Kelowna and Dryden. Yeah. He's now fed on a different route because he's in a different section. So he's over here now. He has all of this front space all the way back to that platform, and he's got a huge hilltop den similar to the one that has. And he's been hanging out up there a lot.
I know, I'm messing with the gate. Hi, mister. Hi. You keep that paw in there.
But what was really funny is Sunday when I came in, I volunteer on Sundays, and I was doing morning supplements, and I was driving down this little road towards Servie, and I had kind of spaced out and forgotten that they moved Nabisco to this enclosure. So I'm driving by and he shot off of that den. It was just this huge flash of white fluff flying up the side of the cage at me. I had totally forgotten that they moved Mr. Spice over here.
We have about 60 cats on 67 acres here in Tampa, Florida. Anyone who's brand new to us, this is Big Cat Rescue. Our official site is bigcatrescue.org. So Nabisco's having a blast. He really likes it over here. Look how fluffy. He needs to be fluffy. This week's been pretty chilly, but by the weekend, we're already going to have highs again in the mid to upper 80s. But right now, this week, it's only been in the 40s and 50s, barely reaching 60. And that's cold to us. Not to mention, almost everybody here at the sanctuary is sick right now. Myself included. Like, I'm fighting it. I'm putting up the good fight at this point. But when it gets this cold and you're already, like, feverish and achy, like, it just feels like knives.
You being a good boy. Such a good boy. You learning the new routine, where the food comes from?
All the cats know the area to hang out where they're going to see the feeders first. Sarah, the youngest cat here at Big Cat Rescue, is Flint Bobcat, and we actually saw him at the beginning of this live. Without looking at their exact dates, I believe after that might be Kimba Tiger and then Nabisco here, but again, it's hard for me to keep every single mind. I'm good going month to month because I'm the one that schedules all the birthdays and anniversaries for the cats, but once that month's move on to the next month, I'm like, oh, new group to memorize.
Feisty.
Jessica, actually, Shiloh is not scared of humans. It's Filmo. And the reason I didn't go over and stop in that area is because the feeders have already come through. And so, because Filmo is very, very scared of people, I don't want to cause him to not eat breakfast just because we want to show him. Oh, and Shiloh lives right next door to him, and so I can't go to Shiloh either because, again, that's going to scare Filmo away from breakfast. We don't want to do that. You might be able to rewind and see a flash of him because when we drove by, he kind of darted. That's why we moved on, because I didn't want to keep him from coming back to eat. So we're just going to do a little drive around here, see who else we might see. But the ultimate goal is we're heading out to Amanda and back towards my office, because I got lots to do today before our staff meeting. There's Miss Servie. We never see Servie.
Hi, Serv. Hi, pretty girl. I know. I'm not the meds person, though.
This is Servie Serval. She's a unique cat. Not very many people feed Servie because she is on meds. She gets a morning supplement, and then an hour later, her meds and breakfast. And I'm a meds keeper, so she's kind of confused. Like, did you bring it, lady?
Sorry.
She is on the same type of medicine that Simba Savannah and Sheena Serval are on. They have like a mosquito allergy or an environmental allergy that causes their little noses to get very bright pink red. So the medication helps keep it healed, and it's usually just a bright pink.
Hi, baby. This is Servie.
Gonna try to take a look at that spot that we just got and make sure that we start trying to show you guys some of the Shire cats. Sometimes the only way to do that is very, very early in the morning or very late at night. So cats like Ariel Bobcat, she's not gonna show you her face unless it's really high up on a platform.
I know, you're excited for breakfast. That's very good.
Sometimes Servie goes through very picky eating stages. There's Zucari running around behind her. He's one of our younger cats as well. You might recall a handful of weeks ago, he was in the hospital because he got a stick stuck in his mouth. He likes to chew on those palm fronds. And the sticks are almost perfectly sized to wedge between the roof of their mouth and teeth.
All right, Servie. Okay.
Same deal. Sheena's like, did you bring the food? I don't like confusing the meds cats in the morning when I'm not the one doing the meds.
This is Hutch. Hutch is very excited because the feeding cart is directly behind me now. I know. Doesn't even faze them that there's walls or doorways or anything.
Lots of food. Shadow out of there. All right. Well, so I had to stop because I started dropping everything off of my cart. The Aries, Orion, and Artemis are enjoying breakfast now. Can see we have to separate them for feeding time. Aries is in the far back corner. We try to double lock him out in the morning because he's so crazy. I don't like to get too close to the cougars when they eat because they will scarf their food very quickly, but Aries is literally already done with his. And Orion's working on his right there. And yeah, this is baby girl up here, Artemis. And then Bethann's feeding Armani leopard next door.
Good job, lady.
Hutch is already done with his breakfast, of course.
Hi, mister! You're being very quiet today. You're being very quiet. Hi! Already done. Already done. Clean plate. Look at that clean plate. Gotta get every last bite. All right, mister. All right, guys. I'm
teenager too, so he's got a big, big space now. He still mostly hangs out on his old side though. But you can be sure if you go over and feed Jinx while he's being, while he's already eaten, he'll go over there and be quite nosy.
I know, it's very cold. When's it gonna warm up? He's like, it's so cold I can't even speak. There's Chaos Caracal over here. What are you saying? I heard you.
He's like, I'm out of here. It's too cold. He did give one little trill back to the food plate area. All right. Let's keep going towards Amanda. That's our ultimate goal here. There's Kali. Are you stalking? What are you doing? Yep, she's stalking. Are you stalking? Hi, baby. This is Kali Tiger.
Where are you going?
I agree. I think I interrupted a Caracal meeting. Here's Jasmine.
Oh. Hi, lady.
This is Jasmine Tiger. Oh, my. Oh, my.
You already got a full belly. I can tell. Full belly. I know this trap. I'm not getting any closer. This is where you spring into action at me. You and Sapphire made a deal.
Oh, how funny. Here comes... Oh, the camera stabilizer froze, but here's Chaos walked all the way over here to see what was happening.
Hi.
So silly. So this is Jasmine Tiger. We'll see Kali again when I go back to my cart. You are very muddy now. Oh boy. Yeah, Sapphire right now. Oh my goodness. She's so filthy. Yesterday when I saw her, the only clean thing on Sapphire were her two front feet. Everything else was gray and black and yellow.
Is that tree yours?
This is Kali Tiger again. Well, we've seen a pretty crazy variety and assortment of cats so far today. So if you're just now joining, you'll want to start from the beginning so you can get updates on all of the cat things from the last week or so.
You know, you'd probably chase me if you could, huh?
And you can always rewatch at dailybigcat.com. Thank you. So Amanda now has this entire spread of cages, but currently she's only in one small section until we know that she's totally and fully out of sedation, because we don't want her in any of the pools. So we're just going to make it a really quick hello, but she is back outside. She's back in her enclosure.
Hi, Amanda. Hi, baby. Hi, sweet girl. Hi. I know. She is doing well. She's been getting treats because she's getting some meds now. I know, darling. Very sleepy still. Such a good girl. So Amanda Tiger, doing really well. She's back outside. She's getting sickles and treats. Just still a little sleepy, which is why we're not allowing her to have full access to the entire enclosure. But I figured you guys would want a little check-in with her. I'm gonna give her her space though. But she's doing pretty darn good for a 24-year-old tiger. So let's end this live over here with baby boy. Very sneaky right now, if you haven't noticed him yet. Hi. Hi, sneaky boy. This is Kimba. You can watch Kimba 24/7 on two different cameras. If you go to bigcatcams.com, you can choose vacation rotation or the feeding camera. Hi, baby boy. I knew you were gonna do that. You're so sneaky. You're so sneaky. You hear that rumbling? He's still waiting on breakfast, I believe, so he's all about the food right now. All about the food right now, sir. Huh. Yes. I hear that grumble. It's a very big boy grumble. Can you hear him? It's a very big boy grumble. So he's in our 2.5-acre vacation rotation. Everybody, well, thank you very much to everybody who helped out in the comments and everybody who shared this live feed today. It does help us reach new people, and those people become the future sponsors of these cats and the donors of these cats. So thank you very, very much. You can rewatch this at dailybigcat.com to rewatch it from the beginning, or right on our Facebook page. Here he goes. Till the next golf cart comes by, and then he'll stalk and chase. So thank you guys. I hope you have a great day.